I want to talk to you about giving and checking the instructions. Because the theme is for teaching assistants, I think it's very important. Actually, it's a key. Good instructions are the key to a successful completion of the task. I myself, very often, when the students are not able to complete the task, I blame myself because it means that I have not set up the task probably the right way. They did not understand how to do it. And I have done some TA work, and I know very often from my own experience that being able to actually translate the instructions for EAO students is a key thing we do when we support students in the mainstream classroom. So, how do we give instructions? First of all, what can we make to make those instructions appropriate to our students? So, we plan, yes, we need to pre-plan the instructions. We need to be aware of our own instructions giving, how we do it. So, it's important that we include only essential information and sequence it in the right order. I suggest everyone spends a couple of minutes when planning the lesson, not only about the content, but also thinking about how am I going to ask the students to do this thing. It's very important in my opinion. Kisses, keep it short and simple. Do not put unnecessary information. Do not speak to students about the things that are very unnecessary, things that are obvious or things they can see for themselves. So there's no point saying, look at this picture at the top of the page. If there's only one picture, they can see it. There's no point saying that. But first of all, before we start giving the instructions, it's important we also attract our students' attention. So we need to make sure we've got the eye contact, complete silence in the classroom. If we need to change the tone of the voice, that's very important, we do it. Without having students' attention, really, no instructions will work because they will not know how to do it. Show how it's done. Simple demonstration or an example. You can use another student to demonstrate something. You can point if it says, don't show something to someone, just say, hide it, don't show. Or if it's something written on paper, circle the word. Highlight, you can highlight the word. Those simple things make a difference. Especially when it comes to the exams. It also teaches the meta-language later on. And also, ask the right questions. So what do I mean by this? I've been asked when I was learning English many times, so can you tell me now what you need to do? It's very, very difficult, okay? We need to ask the right questions to make sure that students understand. What I mean by this, we want to check the instructions, check that students know how to do things. When we ask students, do you understand? How often do you get it? Yes, yes, no, they don't. I don't know, nobody wants to be embarrassed in front of their colleagues, and also I personally sometimes think, oh, I don't want to ask, I don't want to take everyone else's time with my stupid question. No questions are stupid, really. But let's avoid this one. Let's try not to ask, do you understand? Let's find other way of finding out if students actually know how to do a task or not. We need to get a hard evidence. So this hard evidence could be simple checking questions that check the important point of the activity. So, for example, we can ask questions like, which exercise are we doing? If there's more than one exercise on the handout. So, are we doing 2A or 2B? Simple question, a simple answer, 2A. Those questions are very often also closed questions, yes or no. So they do not require a lot of language, but they are, give us evidence to show whether the students understand or not. Are we speaking and writing? As simple as that. If the answer is correct, what do you do? Do you circle? Do you tick? And it's just one word answer again. Are you working alone or in pairs? Do you need to write full sentences or short notes? Are you writing about the present or the past? As simple as that, I think. The most important message from me, I think, about the instructions would be, let's try to keep it short and simple. I really like that KISS abbreviation. It's not always easy. I personally like talking a lot. I'm over my 5 minutes now. But it's important, I very often, when preparing my lesson, actually, I do include a simple checking questions on my lesson plan. 2 or 3 questions, it literally takes a minute, and when you get your head around it, it comes to you automatically.